Hello, I'm Atubo George, and I'm here with my beautiful wife,
Gloria George.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, we are continuing this series. This is a new week, and I thank God for... Now, we've seen some of your comments. We've seen some of the messages you sent to us, you know, and we really appreciate you for recognizing how this broadcast has been a blessing to your life. And our prayer is as we continue. Now, we are trusting God that this whole month we'll be doing this and taking it bit by bit. And like I told you last week, the purpose of this is to bring out God's truth from our experience. Because now, one thing we know we were deliberate about is our experiences must line up with God's truth, God's word. Praise God. So as we do this, we are going to be bringing out the word of God that came to us. So we're not just telling you, one love story. We're telling you our journey in God. And the truth is, God is there for everyone. Anyone who takes a chance with God will get the same results. It's as simple as that. Praise God. Now, before we go on today, can we call for that daily bread? Now, that's so important. It's so important. So even while you're enjoying this broadcast, miracles should be taking place in your life. God should be meeting your needs according to his riches in glory. So are you ready for that? Join us right now and declare, say, Father.
Father.
I receive right now.
I receive right now.
My daily bread.
My daily bread.
It is coming to me now.
It is coming to me now.
Every need that will show up today.
Every need that will show up today.
In my life.
In my life.
Will be matched.
Will be matched.
By your provision.
By your provision.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I demand this.
I demand this.
And so be it.
And so be it.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, we stopped at, I remember last time, this episode 2, we spoke about how we now got to the stage where God revealed to me that you are my wife. Now, let me tell you how that happened. I was on a... Praise God. I remember I was on a 21 days fast. Yeah. And let me not go into why I got into a 21 days fast. Something kind of funny, but I was on a 21 days fast. And during that fast, I made up my mind. I said, okay, Lord, you know what? Why don't we settle this marriage thing once and for all? Because now, several things had happened in my life that, you know, you get to that point where you begin to wonder, come, Lord, is it that you don't want me to get married at all? Just tell me now. Let me know. You know, so I just know that. Because I had made up my mind many years ago that I was not going to commit myself to any lady until I hear from the Lord. I said, this is your wife, you know. So now that was the challenge. You see, you meet with wonderful people and you're like, wow. I mean, and then you're like, okay, Lord, how far? You know, Lord, say, you know, and then the Lord doesn't say anything, and then you're stranded. It can be confusing sometimes because sometimes you just, you know, you get into that point where you want to say, you know, like some people even believe that God doesn't speak where marriage is concerned. Yeah. You better choose who you want to marry and go and get married. Now we're telling you our story. So that's why we are going into these details. But I never believed that, because I remember the point where I deliberately gave God my life. You know what I mean? Beyond I'm born again now, you still get to that point where you make a deliberate commitment to the Lord. Mm-hmm. So now, I had done that, so I know everything about me have to be controlled by God's word. Mm-hmm. Talk less of an important decision like
marriage,
who you're going to spend the rest of your life with. So I was always waiting for God to tell me, okay, go ahead, or this is the person. Mm-hmm. Just somehow you will know that his word has come to you. Mm-hmm. So I was on a 21 days fast. And I remember on the 19th day of the fast, I had this dream where I was telling someone that I know, of course, physically, that, hey, I've decided who I'm going to marry. Now, that's exactly what I said in the gym. I've decided who I'm going to get married to. I'm going to get married to Gloria. You know, and then I woke up from that dream. You know how you wake up and like, what did I just see? You know, what did I just see?
Oh my
like,
goodness.
Nah, it's just a dream.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But why? You know, why?
Why would that dream come to me?
I wasn't saying, oh God, is this my wife or not? Like we told you on the last episode. It's not an issue to say, do I like her or do I not like her? It's an issue, sincerely speaking, it's an issue like, you don't even go there. Like, when you think of it,
I didn't qualify.
She's not even one of those that you say, let me consider. Sincerely now. Now, not because there was anything wrong with her, but the truth about it is, in my eyes, she was just that baby. And literally, she was. It's good.
Even though I was growing now.
Yeah, of course. You know, but you know, see, that's the thing. When you're raising, just like your children, physical children, you never know they've grown up. Something must happen that will let you know that, come, these children are grown up now. Mm-hmm. So I think that's what the issue was, yeah. You know, I remember when I met you, and in my eyes, you were still that person. Now, of course, you've grown, you've experienced, you have more experience. You know, and stuff like that. You know, so, because we even discussed it. I was even waiting for the guy that's the day you were.
Oh, sincerely, you know.
Yes, sincerely, my prayer was that somebody should come and take this, my daughter, away.
Yes, you know,
like,
and I was so looking forward to when you would give me away. My family will be there, of course, but yeah. Then I was always looking forward to you drilling the man that was going to get married.
Yeah, so. So, and then of course, you know, in that whole journey, I know there were several people who would like, oh, I think this guy is liking me and all that. Mm-hmm. And then we'll pray about it, and somehow it doesn't even get to the place of should I decide or should I not decide, just fizzled out, you know, and things like that. So now, so on the 19th day of that 21-day fast, I had that dream. And I woke up, I said, nah, can't be right. How? As in, no. I mean, you know, you see that, you try to think about it, I said, nah. But wait, I was praying to the Lord. So why, what kind of distraction is this?
Fasting.
I was fasting, yeah. What kind of thing is that? Then, so I just let it go. Then on the 21st, on the 20th day, the 21st day, the last day of the fast.
Okay.
The same thing. You know, that morning, I had another dream. And this time around, I was telling, it was clear that, look, this is my decision. This is who I'm getting married to.
Mm.
Now, I know the importance of dreams.
Yeah.
And I know how God communicates. I know when a dream is just a dream.
Yeah.
But then I know when God is communicating. Now,
yeah.
when dreams have definite, clear words in them, you better take seriously those words. And especially when a dream comes in two successions.
Okay.
When you have the same kind of dream twice in a short while.
Okay.
Then you're looking at something that is kind of finalized. You're looking at something that is God's plan. You're looking at something that this is God's decision.
Okay.
Most times, you may not have anything. You can't do anything against it. So, if it's something good, you're seeing something that heaven have settled.
Already.
If it's something bad, then you're dealing with something that you need to now start seeking why God wants that thing to be done.
Yeah.
You may not be able to change it easily like that. Now, I knew, of course, by relating with the Lord, studying, and things like that, I understand those things about it. So when I had that second one, it hits me. It was like, wait, is this what God is really saying? You know how? It's funny now, but you see,
I was just going to say that it's funny now, but then it wasn't.
So I was like, how? Why am I seeing this now? Why why is God doing this to me? That's I really thought, why is God doing this to me? Now, like I said, not because anything was wrong with you, but then it's more like I just see you as a responsibility in my life, as a daughter, someone I'll just be taking care of. You know what I mean by that? Not as someone who can measure up to me as a wife. Yeah. I mean, spiritually. Listen, I see, I never dreamt of having this baby as a wife. You know, my mindset of a wife is someone who's more mature, someone who can, you know, that can kind of, I mean, this is serious. This is serious business, not babyish kind of business. You know, so that was my issue then. Like, Lord, why are you doing this to me? And then I began to pray. Now the fast was over. I knew in my heart that this is what God is saying. But then the question now is why? Why is it, why?
Oh God, help me. I'm just laughing.
Then secondly, I said to myself, I said, if I open my mouth and tell her that I want to marry you, I felt you faint. I just felt like, how would I even say it? How would I communicate that kind of thing? You know, over to you, because number one, I've never been the kind of person who ever want to manipulate anybody. I'm very, very careful about that. That's my kind of person. So even telling you you're my wife, I understand the implication. I understand the fact that if I stand my ground on it, you will have to succumb to it. So that's, I felt this, will this be a free will decision? Or will this just be something that, okay, because I said it, you will have to accept it. Then walking down the line, when I realized that there's a problem we cannot deal with. So what did we get ourselves into? Now, those were my concerns.
So many things, probably.
So I prayed to the Lord. I say, Lord, if this is what you want for me, I don't understand why, but if I know his thought concerning us, they are good. Now, I see all these are deposit of truth that is already in my heart. Okay, so I know his thoughts are good concerning me. So if God is saying, this is my choice for you, then it's got to be good. Even though right now,
if
it was a stranger, maybe I would have believed more. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. But funny enough, how could you believe? You know how our mind works.
I've seen me handle several challenges,
of course,
in life.
Yeah, so yeah, you know those kind of thing that, look, I still have to step in. Praise God. So now I began to pray to the Lord. I said, okay, Lord, you know what? If this is you, I don't know how I'm going to open my mouth to say it to her. But you've got to help me. You just have to help me. I don't know how you're going to do it. You've got to help me. And then I remember one day we were discussing, and the way the word came out of my mouth, you know, I just said, what if God says you are my wife? And then at first he just went, okay, maybe you should talk from that side. If you can remember.
I thought it was a joke. I need to take it seriously.
Yeah. You were like,
just, because, you know, several times you would throw a question at me and kind of like get me engaged in talking about scriptures or probably what the Lord had talked to you about. You just wanted to talk about it. So when that question came, I didn't really think on it. I didn't take it seriously. I was just like, Then I continued. We continued talking. Sincerely, it didn't hit me. I don't think I assimilated that you were even referring to me. It didn't sink at all. So we just continued talking, and then you now said it again.
Yeah. Now, when I said it the second time, sincerely, I didn't say it deliberately. I didn't say it deliberately. We're still talking. It just hit me again. And then it came out of me. I said, but seriously, what if God says you are my wife? Now, when I said it the second time, I heard the Lord say to me, I have helped you. Now carry it on. And so when I said it the second time, go on. See you.
I was stunned. I was quiet for a while. I looked at him. I said, that is not possible. It's not going to happen. And I was like, Lord, why do you want to confuse
my
life?
Yeah, I remember you said that. Why do you want... You were not saying, Lord, why? You were asking me, yes, why do you want to confuse my life?
I was confused. Like, I did not even know what to think. And then after a while, I got angry. I was not like... I stood up like, no, 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 we can't even have this conversation. We are not talking about it. Me, your wife, how? From where? How?
No, sincerely, it was a funny moment. It was awkward. It was...
Afterwards, I didn't talk to him for more than a month, almost 2 months. I didn't talk to him. Mm-mm. I was like, don't even talk about it. Don't bring it up. Don't tell me anything. And funny enough, anytime like I want to even talk to God about it on my own, I'll start crying because I was confused. I felt like, how will I start explaining myself? Like, this person I used to call dad is now going to be my husband.
Yeah.
How are we going to relate? As a young girl, I had expectations of how I was going to be relating with my husband. I used to write a lot. I would write things down, how my marriage would be, how my husband is going to be, what we're going to be doing. And then getting to know God, like really talk about the, really discussing things with God, because sometimes, most times, I was kind of like solo. I used to do a lot of, apart from probably talking to my pastor about stuff, I used to do a lot of talk with me and God, mm-hmm. like just talk to God a lot about things would be going through my mind. I'll just be telling him how I wanted it to be and everything. And then he'll be leading me to scriptures for me to read and see what I was really looking forward to marriage. And I was looking forward to it. I was going to have fun. I was not going to be married to someone that would be, yes, sir. My Lord, you have spoken, so be it. So when he told me, I was like, how are we going to be friends? Like, this is not father daughter. I understood clearly what marriage meant because God had been dealing with me on it. I'd been talking to God about it. I had so many expectations. I told God that if I was going to ever go into a marriage, I don't want my marriage to fail. And if I don't want my marriage to fail, what am I going to do? So God started, you know, teaching me about marriage. I started observing people's marriages. I started reading lots of books. I would love it when, you know, people will be sharing their stories, and every time they'll be saying, my wife and I, my husband and I. And I was just excited, looking forward to this person. Somehow I knew that I was going to marry someone that would love God, because I was telling God, I don't know if the person is going to be a pastor or not. I just want to marry someone that is a man after your own heart, just like David. I want someone that will really love you like I love you and just guide me, and then we'll just be serving God together. Mm-hmm. I didn't want a stereotype relationship that had to do with your husband just being up there and then you are here
just following,
and then you are just following. No play, mm-hmm. no love, no romance in the sense of playing and running around. I used to, I had so many things in my head that I wanted to do with my husband. So I did not see that happen with you at all. So anytime I wanted to pray about it, I would just start crying.
And I remember that whole period. It was like, what have you done to this poor child? You know, because I see the misery. And then I began to think, I'm like, okay, maybe I should withdraw. I should just say, no, it's a joke. Or, because now I'm like, Lord, if this thing is good, it's supposed to be,
I'm supposed to be happy. Excited, you know? I wasn't.
So, but why all this? Then I remember, okay, Lord, what do I do? What do I do right now? Mm-hmm. And then I remember the Lord told me, I should tell you to go talk to someone else, you know? So I'm like, okay. Fine, not me now. Why don't you go talk to someone? And then the first thought, like, who? Because like everybody you will talk to is somebody that is like around me.
Exactly.
You know, that kind of thing.
All the spiritual people like were around.
And people that I've introduced you to, exactly. And things like that, you know. So and then your pastor's wife, I said, okay, why don't you go talk to her? At least she doesn't know me. Mm. You know. Just
personally,
say,
like
yeah,
that.
Personally. Yeah. So why don't you go talk to, that's the church you were attending then.
Yeah.
Why don't you go talk to her and be plain about everything? Tell her how we have known and so stuff like that. And that's Mommy D.
Mommy D. Of
Koza. Yeah.
Yes.
Now, and then you said, okay, fine. I remember what you said then. I said, fine. You are sure when she knows that I'm your spiritual father and blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. I said, okay, fine and good. Mm-hmm. And I said, okay, go. Whatever she tells you to do, do. And that's what I heard in my spirit. So I like, go. I was ready to take that risk. If it's a no, then I know that then maybe I didn't really hear from the Lord. I said, go. Whatever she tells you to do, do. Now, take it off from there.
Okay. So before this counsel came, because of course, I was still taking counsel from you, even in this. Can you imagine? Before this counsel came, I kind of like withdrew from talking to anybody. I was withdrawn. I was really sad. I felt like
God was sentencing you.
I'm telling you, it wasn't funny. I felt like I needed to explain myself to lots of people. And I was beginning to feel bad that why would I want to even do that? Do you understand? Mm. So I didn't want to talk to anyone. In fact, there were several people that I would have loved to talk to. But like you said, I felt they were all connected to you. So yeah. Somehow they were just pushing me to you. So when that, you know, counsel came, I still took my time a little bit before talking about it. And I remember one service, midweek service I went for in church. I was a worker in the Commonwealth of Zion Assembly back then. And I was really blessed being there. I was really following, you know, Mommy D and Pastor then. So one of the services, before I spoke with her, it was a midweek service. So I was sitting down and then Pastor was preaching. And then he started talking about how that sometimes God will even want you to do something and you are fighting it. Why wouldn't you even just say, okay, even if you don't understand something, why don't you even pray about it first? That sometimes it's not every time that everything will be so plain. And it's not every time that you must conclude on something, even when you're hearing something contrary.
Yeah.
So I was like, why is he saying things like this? Because this is what I was going through and I didn't even tell anybody about it. So I kept it in my heart. Then my birthday was like the next week. After that midweek service, my birthday was the next week. So I had prepared some things I was going to take to church for the children. I was working in the children's ministry then. So I had prepared some things I was going to take to church. I was just going to give it to them and then I will leave. Coincidentally, when I went there, Mommy D was there. So she now said, Gloria, come. So she prayed. I told her, oh, it's my birthday. Because I had this habit of always calling my pastors then on my birthday just to bless them. Like, thank you for being a blessing to me. You know, so she called me. I was like, Baba is in the office. I should come so that he will pray for me. I said, okay. So I followed her up to the office and I sat down waiting. Baba had some meetings with people. So I was waiting. And funny enough, the time was dragging. So by the time he came out, there was really no much time for him to talk to me personally. But then he gave me a gift. He gave me some gifts for both of them gave me some gifts for my birthday. And then they gave me a message, one of the CDs that Pastor had preached. And coincidentally was the message of that service that he was talking about, talking to God about things that you don't even want to do or things that you're just fighting, things that you're not just confused about. And that struck me again. I'm like, because immediately I saw the title, I knew what was the content of the message. I'm like, what is even going on here? And then I heard your voice again say, why don't you talk to your Mommy D? I'm like, why is God setting me up like this? I just collected the things. I said, thank you. Then I told her right there that I would love to speak with her. So we fixed another time and we met. And then I talked to her in detail. And then she was like, So, what are you afraid of? Are you not even happy he's a man of God? Are you not even happy that you know his history in Christ? Are you not even happy that someone will be leading you in the way of the Lord? Everything I was expecting her to say.
It's opposite.
I expected her to say, my dear, no, you don't want to be oppressed. You know, men of God, when you are like, maybe in Christ, they will oppress you. She did not say any of that. So she was like, why don't you just calm down. Right now, I understand all the agitations around this. I understand how you feel about this, but I just want you to pray about it. Pray about it, that in her own heart, she doesn't sense any fear. So I should pray about it. So that was when I started praying about it. And the more I prayed about it, the more it looked like you cannot run away from this. But then I asked God one important question. I said, how am I going to relate with him? That's the part that is really bothering me now. Then God told me, said, everything I told you that both of us used to talk about, that's me and the Holy Spirit, me and God, everything he used to tell me about how I should relate with my husband, how I was excited about it. I should just remove Pastor's face from my mind that he's Pastor Atubo. I should just put that picture that I had in my mind that this is the person, and then I should just start relating with the person like that. Then we'll just be taking one step at a time, and then it will just be easy. And then I had several other confirmations after that.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, I know our time is up for today.
Oh.
You know, just like we can just, you know, like I said, I wish this thing was life, but... Yeah. You know, so you take it bit by bit and bit by bit and let it just bless you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, we really have to stop here for today.
Hey.
And then, but we know where we stopped. Yes, so we're going to continue from there tomorrow.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We just want to bless you. We pray, Lord. Our lives have been marked by your voice.
Yes, Lord.
I pray right now for everyone who's watching and listening, who seeks direction in different areas in their lives, especially where marriage is concerned. Either who to get married to or how to continue in their marriage. We ask that your voice will be made available to them.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We're going to continue tomorrow. Bye-bye.